parallelogram method, special method for an ellipse. Here we are having conjugate axis 120 mm, 80 mm, included angle 70. Draw the first parallelogram. Conjugate axis 120 mm, horizontal line, included angle is 70 degrees with an angle of 70 degrees. I am drawing another conjugate axis. This angle is 70 degrees and complete the parallelogram. Now I am naming this. This is going to be P, Q, R, S. Parallel to SR, I am drawing a parallel line. Same length 120. Excuse me. Then draw a parallel line passing through R parallel to PS. We completed the parallelogram PQRS. Locate a midpoint for RS, locate a midpoint for PQ, locate a midpoint for PS, locate a midpoint for QR. You have to join all these points. Now I am naming this as going to be A, B, C, D. CD line and AB line. Now this intersection point is going to be O. So whatever we are applying for the rectangle method, like that, we are applying the same procedure for parallelogram method. Now let us see it. CO is going to be a distance and CP is going to be distance. Now you have to divide the CO line and CP line n number of equal parts. Now n equals to 4. So on the basis of it, 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. Naming it as 1, 2, 3. 4 divisions. C1, 1, 2, 2, 3 and 3 go. Similarly, CP is going to be 4 equal divisions in this direction by acute angle method. So 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. This I am naming it as 1 dash. This is 2 dash. This is 3 dash. This is 4. So in the same procedure like a blank method, A1 dash, then B1 is going to be extended up to this point. Naming this point is P1 in the domain of P. 2 dash A, B2 line extended up to 2 dash A. This is going to be P2. 3 dash A, B3, P3. Similarly, from D, 1, 2, 3. 1 dash, 2 dash, 3 dash. Equal divisions. Here also, 1, 2, 3. A, 3 dash. B3, Q1, A2 dash, B2, Q2, A1 dash,
B1. Q1. This is Q3. Similarly, DR, 4 divisors, 1 dash, 2 dash, 3 dash, in this direction. Now, B1 dash. A1, R1, B2 dash, A2, R2, B3 dash, A3, R3. Similarly, this parallelogram, smart parallelogram, CO, BS. So CS is going to be divided into 4 equal parts, 1 dash, 2 dash, 3 dash, this is 4 dash. Similarly, on the CO line, 1, 2, 3 are existing. Now from this, 1 dash V, A1, S1, 2 dash B, A2, S2, 3 dash B, A3, it becomes S3. Now I have to join all the concern points. C, P1, P1 to P2, P2 P3, P3 to A, A3 to Q1, Q3, sorry, A2 through Q3, Q2, Q1, Q1 to D, D1 to R1, R1 to R2, R2 to R3, R3, R3 to B, B to S3, S3 to S2, S3 to S1, and S1 to C. Now, SR and SP are conjugate axes. How to determine the major axis and minor axis for this ellipse in parallelogram? Now, let us consider O is the center. Which is the center? O is the center. O is a center. And radius more than OA. Radius more than OA. O is the center, radius more than OA. Draw one circle by using a compass. So some distance it is going to be more than VA, like that. So draw one circle. This circle is going to be cuts the ellipse at certain points. Name those points 1, 2, 3, 4. Now join the points 1 and 2. Join the points 3 and 4. For 1 and 2 point, locate a midpoint. And for 3 and 4, you have to locate a midpoint. For 1 and 2, this is going to be midpoint. I am assuming this is going to be midpoint. Let us assume one member. For 3 and 4, this is going to be midpoint. Now, how to join midpoints as a straight line? Now, it is going to be its major axis. Major axis. Now, I am naming it as major axis EF is major axis. Passing through O-th point, draw a perpendicular to EF. It is going to be its minor axis. GH is minor axis. Now how to draw the tangent and normal for this curves? Now consider a point J. Now half of the major axis EO is going to be its radius, G is going to be center. Cut the major axis, you will get F1 and F2. Join the points F1J, JF2. F1J, F2. For this one, you have to draw a perpendicular bisector. It is going to be its normal. So therefore, N1, N2, normal. Passing through J, draw a perpendicular to N1 and N2. This is going to be its tangent. T1 and T2. Thank you.